Hello friends, and welcome to another video by Engineering Today. Hope you and your family are safe and healthy. We already updated you that SpaceX has already created history as SpaceX Crew Dragon capsule C206 has safely landed on the Earth. So the obvious question is, what's next? The SpaceX's crew capsule was given the name Endeavour by two NASA astronauts, Doug Hurley and Bob Behnken. After spending 64 days, this test flight to International Space Station, the first human-rated spaceship by SpaceX, has already landed on American soil. Now it's as envisioned by SpaceX CEO Elon Musk, the main objective will be to prepare for the next launch reusing the same spacecraft. So SpaceX Demo 2 Crew Dragon will now go through a process of inspections, upgradation, and refurbishment before the next mission, which is planned with a four-person crew next spring. SpaceX and NASA will be engaged in a substantial inspection process of the spacecraft, having the inspection model already set up in case of capsule C206. If it's found good by both SpaceX and NASA, the inspection process this time could be a surprisingly short one. SpaceX already has considerable amount of experience gained observing Crew Dragon Demo 1 C201 and in-flight Abort C205 test flights and recoveries. Benji Reed, SpaceX's Director of Crew Mission Management, confirmed that the exterior panels of the Crew Dragon will be removed by SpaceX team at Cape Canaveral and start the inspection process. He said, "We want to make sure that we kind of dig deep and understand everything that's gone on with this vehicle, make sure we're really ready to go, and then do some of the aspects of the refurbishment. There are some things that we will replace, some things that are standardly replaced, some things we want to upgrade based on lessons learned, or that we already planned in work. For future relaunch missions, building the trunks will play a vital role, as SpaceX would need to build a new trunk for each mission. Trunks mainly provides electrical power, with solar arrays and radiators to stabilize temperatures inside the spaceship. It's an unpressurized module which gets mounted to the rear of the spacecraft. The trunk is normally chucked out before re-entry and burns up in the atmosphere." Regarding this, Benji Reed said, "We have to produce a new trunk for each flight. For this flight, we'll have upgraded solar panels." Reed also confirmed the spacecraft will be almost entirely reused, apart from some upgradation and refurbishment. Let's get into some more details of SpaceX Crew Dragon recovery and refurbishment process. It was a successful demonstration of splashdown by SpaceX, establishing solid confidence gained from NASA. Demo 2, the designated test flight, was the first of its kind having astronauts on board. For regular crew rotation, NASA would need to complete the inspection process from their side and certified Crew Dragon as reviewing all the data available. Two NASA astronauts, Doug Hurley and Bob Behnken, were assisted by recovery personnel from NASA and SpaceX after landing. SpaceX recovery team was available to recover the capsule from the water. The recovery team split locations to send two recovery ships, the Go Searcher and the Go Navigator, between the Gulf of Mexico and the Atlantic Ocean, off the coast of Florida, loaded with 40 personnel from SpaceX and NASA. They're mainly spacecraft engineers, water recovery experts, medical professionals, ship's crew, NASA cargo experts, and backup team to assist in the recovery. Hurley and Behnken were taken back to Houston by plane, whereas SpaceX's recovery ship returned to Port Canaveral on Florida's East Coast. A team of engineers and technicians were available at Port Canaveral to transfer the spacecraft to a facility at Cape Canaveral Air Force Station for further processing. At Cape Canaveral Air Force Station, there's a facility known as Area 59. Once this area was used to ready Air Force GPS navigation satellites for launch. Now it's been under SpaceX management for Crew Dragon program, and the refurbishment process of the Crew Dragon will also take place in this facility. Though the past missions using earlier Dragon design were executed and ended with splashdown in the Pacific Ocean off the coast of California, this time the crew program manager from SpaceX decided to move the return location to the Atlantic Ocean or Gulf of Mexico off the Florida coast, as it's closer to the refurbishment facility at Cape Canaveral. Due to weather concerns in the Atlantic for Hurricane Isaias, the splashdown for Demo 2 happened in the Gulf of Mexico. By March 2021, the second SpaceX Crew Dragon flight is planned to be launched. Earlier this year, on the 3rd of June, in a statement from NASA, it was told that SpaceX Commercial Crew contract had been revised, and they now have permission to reuse SpaceX Falcon 9 boosters and Crew Dragon capsules too, as their astronauts are planned to be launched in the future. With that unexpected announcement from NASA, it was expected that SpaceX could begin reusing Falcon 9 and Crew Dragon on Crew 2, and NASA might consider the feat in 2021 or 2022. It was stated by both SpaceX and NASA in several media events before, during, and after Crew Dragon's first crewed reentry and splashdown that the actual plan was to reuse Demo 2 Crew Dragon on Crew 2. SpaceX has signed contracts to fly six of these post-certification missions by the mid-2020s for NASA. A similar contract is also there between NASA and Boeing for six crew rotation flights on the Starliner crew capsule. It's yet to be launched for test flight with astronauts. SpaceX engineer Kate Tice said that they've made remarkable progress, and the Crew Dragon refurbishment process will be relatively quicker than Cargo Dragon. It may require only 6 months or less between orbital flights, which indicates that in future, NASA and SpaceX will have considerable amount of buffer schedule for reusing spacecrafts and C206. The Crew Dragon capsule may get installed by the end of 2020 to launch Crew 2. The original proposal from SpaceX to reuse Crew Dragon spacecraft on astronaut missions was presented in 2014 after NASA selected SpaceX to develop and fly its crew capsule. At that time, SpaceX's proposal was to return Crew Dragons using propulsive onshore landing rather than splashdowns at sea. Later, this idea was dropped by SpaceX, and they had an agreement with NASA to fly new Crew Dragon vehicles on astronaut missions. In the meantime, SpaceX's experience on the refurbishment process got a different dimension when successfully executed splashdown of Cargo Dragon in saltwater. Following this progress, NASA also agreed to send their astronauts on SpaceX's reused Crew Dragon and previously flown Falcon 9 rocket boosters in June. Jim Bridenstine, the NASA administrator, said, "Our desire as an agency has been for sustainability, and that means reusability." He added that their agreement with SpaceX to fly astronauts on reused capsules fits with NASA's strategy. SpaceX's president and chief operating officer Gwynne Shotwell said, "The capsule is designed for 5 to 10 missions. We'll have to see how things work out after we examine the capsule when it gets back to port and back to the Cape for our facilities there. But based on the telemetry and any visible indications that we've had so far, the vehicle looks like it's in really good shape." Benji Reed said, "You learn so much from a vehicle that can refly, and you also have to build it better. You have to build it more robustly for a vehicle that you know you need to use multiple times." The SpaceX Crew 2 mission will be under control of veteran astronaut Shane Kimbrough, who's logged 189 days in orbit on two previous missions to the International Space Station. His first one was a NASA space shuttle, and then a six-month expedition in 2016 and 2017. During this phase, Shane launched and landed on a Russian Soyuz spacecraft. A veteran of 13-day space shuttle flight in 2009, NASA astronaut Megan MacArthur will be on command as the pilot. She's married to Bob Behnken. Bob said, "It's definitely her turn to focus on getting her mission while I take care of things that need to be taken care of for our home life." As per Shotwell, "Megan is first and foremost an astronaut when it comes to our perspective." She also added, "We'll make sure that that vehicle is as good or better than the vehicle that Bob flew in. What we did for Bob, I think we can do an even better job for Megan. And I hope she's really excited to fly in this particular capsule. I was really excited to have her named the pilot for the Crew 2 mission." Megan and Shane will be accompanied by Japanese astronaut Akihiko Hoshida and European Space Agency astronaut Thomas Pesquet on the Crew 2 mission. According to Steve Stitch, NASA's manager for Commercial Crew Program, SpaceX's proposal to reuse the Crew Dragon spacecraft was a reasonable thing to do. He said, "I think part of the question was, how long does it take to refurbish the vehicle? It takes about 4 months or so. We have a lot of margin getting to the flight in the spring timeframe for Crew 2. The vehicle, as gets back to Area 59 at the Cape, it'll start going through its maintenance. That's all for today, and we'll come back soon with all the latest news. By the way, we've planned to present you videos on interesting personalities related to space research. We already added one on SpaceX CEO Elon Musk. Please watch it. We hope you like it. Till then, goodbye and take care. Thanks for watching. Please subscribe for more videos like this. Hit the like button if you find the video interesting. And kindly provide your valuable feedback in the comment section. This will help us to improve.